What's up, all you sexy buddy fighters? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Before we begin, you must be thinking, dude, STD02 Beijing Overcash comes out tomorrow. What the hell are you doing with this crowd right now? Okay, chill the final phase out. I'm sorry, guys. You know, for the past 2 weeks, I kind of fell sick and I really didn't feel like doing anything. But now I'm back to do more Buddyfight videos. Oh my god. Yeah, so I know WGP is also coming up. So I'll try to do even more Buddyfight videos for you guys. I know you've probably seen this already, so it could be a fun video to watch. This is my third trial deck and I haven't got my SB foil flag. You know, I'm still hunting for it. I don't think I'll ever get it. But you viewer might just be my lucky star to opening it. And I need them views, so watch it. Now, before we begin, let's look at this custom playmat made by Bushiroad. You know, I think 2 months ago, I entered into an Intershop Challenge tournament where I represented a shop and their other shop representatives as well, and we clash it out. And the winner will get a custom playmat made by Bushiroad with the shop you're representing. For me, it's Royal Video imprinted onto the custom playmat. And it's really cool because at that time, there was nothing much for Buddyfight, and Bushiroad actually made the effort to host a tournament and have amazing custom prizes like this, which is really awesome. Thank you, Bushiroad. And this playmat is really limited, you know. I think the shop also got a few, so if you go to the shop and enter their tournaments, you might actually win one of these custom playmat as well. Beautiful custom playmat. Over here with the ferocious Blade Centaur Gaga from War of Dragots, and over here is Vanguard Dragonic Blaster Tiger. And over here we have the amazing gold metal looking plated Fawn of Champion imprinted into this amazing playmat. Alright, so today I'll be reviewing the Legend of Double Horus trial deck. If you haven't already known, this is the one with the double body, and over here is a little pharaoh. You know, I really love this character. It looks amazing, you know. At the side of the box, we have the art, which is really, really nice. You know, over here is the card list. You know, some of the cards don't have 4 quantities and they are really important, so I recommend at least getting 2 of these trial decks. You know, very beautiful. And I'll also be showing you a little bit on how you can upgrade your deck. This is the Legend of Horus secret pack, and also these are the stuff I usually use for my cards. This is Bushiroad sleeves, you know, it helps to protect your cards. And this is the double layer, you know, it protects your sleeves in case, you know, sometimes your sleeves might get split up, split ends. So this is the green Bushiroad double sleeve. Is this the matte one? Because sometimes in tournament, your hand kind of gets a little sweaty, and the green matte one has this function where it's non-stick, which is really amazing, guys. Alright, let's open this baby up. So here we have the deck, and oi, 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 SP flag! Wow! Wow! Wow, guys! Here's the SP flag, man! Wow, you guys are my lucky star, man! Whoa, woo! After 3 attempts, oh my gosh! Here's the SP flag, guys! Oh, I got it, yo! Wow, guys, I mean, we did it, man! Whoa! Holy cow! Wow, I finally got my Pharaoh, man! Wow, this will go along very amazing against my Buddy Rare, man! Wow, amazing! Surashi! Okay, man, let's... Okay, wait, let's leave this up, man. Wow, this is crazy! Oh, guys, I can't believe it, man. You know, I knew it, man. Third time's a charm, right? And I think it's you guys, man, you know. The moment I filmed it, right, the legend, a normal legend world flag immediately turned into a foil flag. Wow. Okay, so let's take a look at what's inside the packaging first. We have a life counter, really beautiful, by the way. You know, over here, you have the normal. This is the playmat. Okay, behind is what's interesting. Wow, take a look at this. Very interesting to read, you know. You can read during your free time, some strategies. Wow, say, I'm so happy, man. Okay, over here, comics. As predicted, you know, never change. Alright, over here, same old stuff. Put that away. And you know, this life counter is beautiful. You know, they finally got the perfect dimensions for this life counter. I know back in the days where, like, I don't know why, but the production, they just they just managed to mess it up, you know, and the, it was so tight. But now nowadays, the life counters are perfect, man. You know, this is always what I've been looking for. And this beautiful life counter goes well, amazingly well, perfectly with the deck. Now, let's put this aside. Oh my gosh, guys, take a look at this. Beautiful, man. Wow. Finally, let's put him in the middle, man. All right, so let's get on with the deck. Over here we have legendary flame deity Magma Horus. So you can double buddy, call cost pay 2 gauge. When this card enters the field by effect of the ice legend of ice deity Freezer Horus, destroy all monsters on your opponent's field and deal 1 damage to your opponent for each card destroyed. Very powerful. And over here we have the next legend of ice deity Freezer Horus. Okay, so P2 gauge, double buddy call. When this card enters the field by buddy call, you may buddy call a legend deity, Magma Horus, which is him, without paying his call cost at the start of your attack phase. Legendary flame deity Magma is on your field. For this turn, all monsters on your field gets penetrate and double attack. So it's really amazing. So look at the art. Wow, it kind of joins into this legend thing. However, you know, the secret pack one actually is, if you use the secret pack one, you can't really use this together because the secret pack one will only be able to call the secret pack Magma Horus, which is, you know, it's all right. So this is a more of a trial deck exclusive one. So you have to buddy call the blue one in order to special buddy call into the red one to gain all their effects. So we will get four of Magma. And four of Freezer Horus. No, got me for a second. Okay, next is a High Priest of Harvest, Mosun. We will have two copies of him. It's a size 3, 12 to 12, very big stats. Call cost, drop 2 hand cards. Say what? Counter. During each player's attack phase, call this card from your hand by paying its call cost. Okay. If this card is in the center, this card on the field gets size reduced by 1 for each monster on your left and right. So, okay, it technically becomes a size 1, you know, but yeah, drop 2 hand cards unless you have cards that when you drop has effects, then be good. Plus, you know, there's actually a double rare which allows you to recall your buddy, which is much better than this card in my opinion. Next up, we have two copies of Warrior of Zeal Terrias. So, call cost, pay 1 gauge, put the top card of your deck into it. So, if this card is in your center, when a Legend Dragon monster on your left or right attacks, deal 1 damage to your opponent, penetrate, so got pretty good. You know, you can deal damage to counter the buddy block, you know, because buddy block, yeah, burn damage still gets through. Next, we have two copies of Breeze Barrier Garrick. If this card is in the center, all abilities of Land Dragon on your field cannot be nullified by opponent card effects. When this card is destroyed, stand all Legend Dragon in your buddy zone. Pretty good, you know. This card is actually pretty good because once you buddy call, you can't actually do the double buddy call again unless you restand the cards in your buddy zone, which is really amazing. You'll gain extra life as well. Really good. Okay, four copies of Wandering Merchant Ota. So pay 1 life. When this card enters the field, look at the top 3 cards of the deck, put up one of legend monster or item among them in your hand and drop the rest. Wow, this is pretty good, man. Move. So it's top 3 searches, really actually pretty amazing. So this is the one I use in my main deck, Devoting Mummy Maker Judah Lush. So you actually need to buy 2 trial decks to get 4 copies of him. So when this card is dropped from your hand, charge 2 gauge. And when this enters the field, if a legend dragon is on your field, gain 1 life and draw a card. So it's really amazing. It helps you gauge, you know, if you do not have good cards, you just can just call him and draw another card. Really amazing. And a reprint of Owl Widow. Wow, this is amazing. So when this card is dropped from your hand, charge and draw. Very basic. Also, I recommend buying 2 trial decks to get a play set of him because you definitely want to play 4 of him. Alright, 4 copies of Wyrmling of the Rocks Risha. When this card is dropped from your hand, charge a gauge and gain a life. At the end of the battle of this card, you may return this card from your field to hand. So I would say definitely charge gauge and draw a card is better, as well as charge 2 gauge, because this Legend Horus deck can be very gauge heavy when you call the freeze Horus of 2 gauge. Okay, next up we have 4 copies of Inheritance of Honor Tara. So choose when use one of the following 2. Put a top card of your gauge for each card in your buddy zone. And also you gain 1 life for each card in your buddy zone. So technically charge 2 or gain 2 life. Or in the future where there's actually triple buddy, new support, you know, you can actually charge 3 or gain 3 life. Very good. Alright, we have 2 copies of Dagla Lebak. So you may only cast this card if you got 2 or more Legend Dragons on your field. Pay 1 gauge, gain a life and draw 2 cards. Very amazing card. Definitely need to play in your deck. You know, I'll recommend maybe playing 2 to 3 copies of him. 4 might be a little bit too much. Okay, now 2 copies of Fire and Ice. Fire and Ice. Okay, drop a hand card and pay 1 gauge. Put up to 1 Legendary Flame Deity Magma Horus and up to 1 Legendary Ice Deity Frieza Horus from your deck into your hand. Shuffle your deck. You may only cast this once per turn. This is really good. However, there is actually an upgrade, a triple rare version available in the set where you're actually able to stand your buddies at the same time and search your deck for the Magma Horuses as well. Very good card. Next up, Yunogat. So drop a hand card and draw 2 cards. Very amazing. Unfortunately, they only have 1 copy. It is a reprint of a very hard to get double rare. And, you know, I'm happy with that. You know, at least they actually reprinted this, which is very good in this deck to filter out your hand and as well gain additional effects as well. So definitely at least play 2 copies. You know, maybe you can play 3 of him. Okay, Frozen Circulation. We have 4 of him. So you can basically nullify the attack, gain 1 life for each card in your buddy zone. Alright, it's a pretty decent nullify. Nullify, gain 2 life. Okay, we have 2 copies of Arami Red Hot. So pay 1 life, choose a legendary on the field for this thing, gets 6,000 power and defense and counter attack. Okay, so it's pretty meh. Next, we have Elunid's Ring. So you may only cast this card if you're being attacked. Nullify the attack, then drop a hand card. If you do, draw a card and gain 1 life. You know, pretty good because, you know, you can drop cards which has a special card effects. However, in the set, they also have another shield which actually allows you to cast it, nullify the attack. And then if you drop a hand card, you know, use this effect, you can get the shield back to your hand, which is really amazing. This card is also pretty good as well. Okay, 2 copies of Staff of Mataf. So pay 1 gauge, all size 1 dragon on your field cannot be destroyed or returned to your hand by opponent card effects. Activate during your attack phase. Choose a legend dragon monster on your field. Rest this card. If you do, stand a card and draw a card. So this is like the Dimension Dragons item. You know, restand, draw a card, and your legend dragon gets to attack again. Pretty okay. Next up is Scepter of Medan. Pay 1 life, all Legend Dragon monsters on your left and right gets power plus 5,000. Activate, choose a Legend Dragon monster in your drop zone. You may rest this card. If you do, put the chosen card into your hand. So now this is the item I actually use it in my main deck because number one, you are paying life for the core cost rather than gauge. In the deck actually requires a lot of gauge. And also you can actually find one card from your drop zone, replenish it every single turn and return it to your hand. Also, it gives your Legend Dragon plus 5,000 power, which is important because sometimes there is not enough power to beat through tanks from your opponent, which is really amazing. I still use this weapon. Very amazing item. Okay, and finally, we have 4 copies of the Impact Judgment of Ice and Flame, Da'awa Hajuma. So you may only cast this card if your opponent life is 4 or less, standard stuff. You have a dragon and a king on your field. Pay 3 gauge, deal 4 damage to your opponent. This damage cannot be reduced. So that's it for the trial deck. Now we look at a secret pack. Now this is where things start to get a little bit more fun. Alright, so for the secret pack, they actually use a different buddy. Okay, first up is Flame Deity Magma Horus. So double buddy gift. When this card enters the field by effects of Ice Deity Frieza Horus, which is this card, destroy up to 2 cards on your opponent's field and draw 2 cards. At the start of your attack phase, if Ice Deity Freezer Horus is on your field, for this turn, all Dragon on your field get triple attack. Woo! Wow, that is powerful. I mean, it is very important because of the draw power. Now, this makes the whole deck very, very much more powerful. I definitely recommend changing into these buddies because they really is what makes the deck very powerful. And take a look at the art, you know, they actually combine. So, in future, there will be a triple buddy which comes in the center and it's going to be amazing. You know, it's a really awesome, very fun mechanic. The triple buddy is very, very, very powerful. Okay, so now we look at Ice Deity Freezer Horus. Pay 2 gauge. When this card enters the field by buddy call, you may buddy call a Flame Deity Magma Horus without paying its call cost. All Dragon and King on your field cannot be destroyed or returned to your hand by your opponent card effect. So it has that immunity, that very powerful immunity. Also, what's strong about this deck is when you buddy call, every time you double buddy call, you gain 2 life. And there's stuff to restand your buddy. You know, you keep on gaining life and that amount of advantage, you know. Definitely, I recommend tagging in stuff like Lost World. There's so many different things and so many mechanics in Legend World, which is very powerful that you can play. Okay, so next up we look, Heavy Shield of Edgevoyance Corsex. So this, the spell you cast with Shield and its card name cannot be nullified. Pretty normal. When this card is dropped from your hand by card effects, send all Legend Dragon in your buddy zone. This card is pretty meh, I would say, because there are other cards which helps you stand cards from your buddy zone, which has other effects as well, which is much better than this. So I wouldn't really recommend playing this card. The buddy is the what's in the secret pack, which is very, very important. Next up, we have Seed of Absolute Hierarchy Throne. Wow, I'm Hieratic Throne. So pay 1 gauge, if a Dragon on your field would leave the field, you may put this card from the field into the drop zone if the card remains on the field. So activate, rest this card. If you do, look at the top 5 cards from your deck, put up to 1 Legend Dragon monster among them into your hand and the rest into the bottom of your deck in any order. What sets aside this card from the one in the trial deck, which is this card, is the fact that, you know, sometimes at rare occasions when I draw my hand, I get this item. There isn't a monster in my drop zone for me to take. However, if my hand is kind of like brick, you know, I can actually use this item and check top 5 and still be able to look at, still be able to search out, you know, something from my deck, like a Legend Dragon monster, which is really good. The only downside about this card is the gauge cost. So that's what really sets aside people from choosing this card and this card. And also this one, you can actually choose from a variety of cards in your drop zone. So yeah, so some people might actually choose this card over this card. But however, this card is still pretty good in my opinion. It also gives that one times protection for your Dragons. And the impact we have, wow, take a look at this art, guys. It is beautiful. Wow, Forbidden Light of the Double Deity, Acta Pedo. So you may only cast this card if a Dragon and a King are on your field. Pay 2 gauge, deal 2 damage to your opponent for each Dragon monster on your field, then end the final phase. So technically you are dealing 4. If you have the double buddy, that makes it 6, and it's crazy. So, you know, right now it's 4, is pretty normal. But however, this is a direct upgrade to the trial deck's impact. So as you can see, by purchasing the secret pack alone, you're already using you can upgrade up to 4 cards from the secret pack right into the deck, which is really, really amazing. So I definitely recommend slowly, if you're playing this deck, you know, slowly farm for the secret pack, you know, it's worth it, you know, for the double buddy. So we've come to the end of the video. Wow, what an amazing pull. Couldn't have done it without you guys. Awesome, man. Also, Blazing Overclash comes out tomorrow. You know, do remember to check out Buddy Dash Mart for sale for singles. Also, we do have a discount code. Do remember to use it. And guys, you guys know the drill. It's time to buddy fight.